Transformers, more than meets the eye. Autobots wage their battle to destroy the evil forces of...
Hello everybody, this is Toys R Us, and for this new figure unboxing and review, we're going to be looking at the Shattered Glass Autobot Goldbug. So, quite a bit to do in this video, so we're going to unbox him live in a second, have a look at everything that comes inside the packaging. We're going to have a quick look at him with some other figures that also use the same mold, which we've got him, and of course another Bumblebee. We're also going to do some comparisons with him and some other Goldbug and Goldfire, as this guy was known, toys that have also been released. And I also want to do as well, I want to get him together with some of the other figures that have been released in this toy line, because this Shattered Glass toy line I'm super impressed with. I'm really pleased that they've brought it into the mainstream, and again, everybody's getting to experience what a great idea it is. Right, before we get started and before we open it up, let's have a look at this amazing packaging too. And again, it really is. And it's so good. I was just so pleased that when they said that these were going to be special editions from Hasbro Pulse. I know you can get them elsewhere as well, but I was just really pleased that obviously we weren't going to be like the Generation Selects, just brown cardboard boxes. Right, there he is on the back. We can see that it's going to take 22 steps to transform him. It does of course look like we're using the Cliff Jumper mold, which has been used, which you've just seen, for Bug Bite and Netflix Bumblebee. And there again is some brilliant artwork of him. One quick thing before we go into the packaging, we also got the comic as well. If I want to be a bit negative, this is number 4, and I think that's because they've been released in different orders. So the last one that we've got in the UK was Megatron and number 2, because Starscream was number 3. So if you want to read it, you can't, they're all out of sync until we get number 3. But let's have a look at the actual figure then. And I was again really lucky. I've heard some more horror stories of these turning up completely damaged, completely bashed. I've just realized I should have taken it out of the bottom. Let's take it out of the bottom. It's far easier, just the one bit of tape. So used to opening everything from the top. Let's have a look at him then, nice and careful. I don't really want to damage the box. I want to keep it as best I can. Well, there you go. As you can see, it's not coming out very easily at all. There he is in his plastic casing. And again, this is brilliant because that is some lovely artwork there of him. Right, what I'm going to do now then, I'm going to just quickly take him out of his plastic casing and I'll come straight back to you. Right then, we're back, and as you can see, I've set him free from his plastic casing, and he's got quite a few accessories to be honest. But before we look at them, let's have a look at the actual bot itself. And I'm absolutely loving this head sculpt. I think it looks brilliant. It's brilliant with the red eyes, and of course there with the purple Autobot logo. You will of course have articulation in the head. You can turn it around. It'll move slightly backwards and forwards as well, but literally only slightly. We'll do a quick look at the articulation, but because it is a new figure, we know that there's loads of it. So shoulders all the way around out to the side, elbows or bicep joints backwards and forwards, wrist twist, waist twist, yep, hips, knees, and of course ankle rock, everything that you'd expect with a brand new figure. And of course we do know that this mold has been used before, and again, I'm just really liking it. You could also, if you want, you can disconnect this so it hasn't got to be on the back. I think it looks really stunning. There's loads of parts to come with him. The instructions again have gone that lovely color scheme, basically with the Shattered Glass, which they're using for all of them. So even though it's an Autobot or a Decepticon, they're using exactly the same color scheme. What I'm going to do now though is I'm going to quickly come back with you guys. There's going to be this alternate mode, and the transformation process is going to be on a separate video. Okay, as you can see, we are back, and here he is, his alternate mode, and it's brilliant. It's stunning. I'm still yet to track down a Cliff Jumper from the War for Cybertron trilogy, which is of course the original owner of this mold, but I have obviously got the Bug Bite and the Netflix Bumblebee, and I just really like it. I think the detail is brilliant. Again, you can even see some brake discs behind there in the wheels. The color scheme looks brilliant. Again, this lovely translucent plastic in the window. And what I really like about this mold and the transformation process, which again you can see in another video, I just want to keep the length of this video down for now, is that it's just so neat and tidy. I mean, the only thing that's going to give it away that it's a bot underneath there, if you want to be super picky, as you can make out that they are his fists. His head is all tucked away inside. You can't really see anything. It's stunning. Okay, so the alternate mode is like a hybridizing mix of two particular cars, a Porsche 924 Turbo and a Mitsubishi Starion. I hope I pronounced that right. I'm not too good on my cars, but yeah, it just clicks and it all fits together really, really nice. Now, he's got an abundance of accessories here, and I suppose this is where the fun starts, and this is why I really like this mold, and I was excited to get this figure. So you've got so many accessories that you can literally attach to him as well. So we can, first and foremost, we can make the large gun, and that is, of course, by getting all the pieces together like so. We're literally going to attach these all like this, and then this bit at the back, and then we've now got the struts, and it's up to you where you want to put these. You can put these at the front to start off with if you like so. And again, there are a number of holes on here where you can put this. We're just going to put this on the roof for now, and there's the two holes obviously at the bottom. So the main way that you can sort of pop that on is exactly as you can see it there, and it just, again, it works really, really well. It is, it's so good. And then I think, I suppose, the best one, which completely blew my mind when I did it with the Bumblebee one, again because I've missed the cliff jumper version, is the fact that you can attach all these now. So these are going to be skis. So underneath, you've got literally, you've got holes here, there, there, you've got tabs here, there and there. So first and foremost, we're going to pop the skis on. We're going to pop these, let's hope they stay in because it's a brand new toy. I've just put that on the wrong side, haven't I? There we go. Of course, you want the ski to go under the wheel. Corrected it there before I managed to do it. Yep, that's it. Oh no, I needed it at the front, see? So not only did I put it on wrong, I put it on backwards. It was the right side. There you go. That is where it's supposed to go. Third time lucky. And then this one is going to go here as well. That is super tight. Then what we're going to do is we're going to attach, you can see this tab there now really quite clearly, and there's cutouts on the side as well as there. So you've got two choices, to be honest, but we're going to put this right here like so, and the same on the other side with the cutout like that. And I'm just going to literally rest him there for a few seconds just so you can see how that looks. I'm sure you'll agree that it does look really, really good. You can as well, there's one more piece left, which is this, and you can even store this underneath as well by folding it out like that. And then underneath here, you can see there we've got yet another hole where we can then attach, or, oh, I've just really knocked the front out. We can clip all this in. In fact, I probably should have turned it the way around. Now, there we go, it fits lovely, because what you can do is you can line these two dowels up into there. I don't know what I was referring to when I said turn it around, but there you go, look at it. It just looks brilliant. It looks even better in these colours. It really does. Super, super impressive. And again, it's a brilliant way of the fact that you can store everything in his alternate mode without having to worry about losing any of the accessories. Right, we're going to come back for the final time then in his robot mode with some comparisons with how to use his accessories. And yeah, let's round it off by doing all that. Okay, here he is back in his robot mode, but this time I've actually left the whole back of the car off intentionally. And that's basically to show you that you can use this as an accessory as well. So you can use this as a shield. So you've got, that's where it was connected into in car mode. And then you've got this part here. If you wanted to, and this is how it comes packaged, this will fit into that hole there, and that's how it came out of the box, if you remember. But otherwise, as I say, you can, if you want, you can take this out and then you can use this as a shield as well. So we can use that as a shield, pop that there, and then again, we've got a couple of choices. Before I build the gun up fully, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just, yeah, in fact, let's just do the double gun. So you can do the double gun like so, pop this in his hand, and then we can even have this piece that looks, it's starting to get daft already. And the only problem with this figure is because he's so small, obviously it can sort of counterbalance him, so that's why it's quite good. And what I did with Bug Bite, funnily enough, was I did put everything on the back just to counterbalance him. I'll just move him over here for a second. I'll keep him in shot actually. But you can then attach this. This was the bit that I put upside down wrong underneath. You can fold it out. Well, sorry, it was folded out, but you can bring it this way. And what there is here, you can see there is a cutout there, or a little slot again. And then you've got a slot there right on the underside. And then you can pop this in. And it looks a bit more impressive when it's when the arm's down. So what we're going to do, if I bend at the bicep joint there, so it looks like it's got a little mini rocket launcher there as well. And then it obviously looks a lot better if you were to split the guns in two, like so. There you go. So many things. We can, of course, do the main weapon that was, of course, used by Cliffjumper, and it was even shown in the cartoon as well. So one of the very first episodes, I think. So we're going to pop this all the way there. We can put the struts on again, like so. And we can then attach this into place. And then, of course, pop this right up on his shoulder like that. Oh, I've spun it all around. There we go. Giant gun mode. To be honest, that's pretty much exactly how I display him, this guy as well. So that's how I display him. So that's the only three uses of the mold that I've got. I know there is a hubcap, but he's not available in this country at all anywhere. And as I've already stated, I completely missed Cliffjumper, not realizing how good he was. So there are some comparisons of the use of the same mold. Let's have a look now at just a couple of other gold bugs and gold fires, shall we say. So there's his original self. Absolutely no comparison whatsoever. Although what I do like is, let's just take this gun out of his hands. Although obviously they've changed the colours for the shattered glass, you can see that the head sculpt is a really good homage to the original generation one. It's pretty much the same. Apart from the fact that, of course, you've got the colours inverted and you've got the nice red eyes, because he's pretty much a baddie, isn't he? And then we've got this guy here, and this guy's one of the last figures made of Gold Bug, or Gold Fire in this particular case, as he was known as. And he was released with the Thrilling 30 lineup of figures. And this guy, again, just absolutely blows that figure away. But then what I also think is really good, and it's just this whole shattered glass theme. I think it's fantastic. So we've got them in a funny order in the UK, because obviously Goldbug was number 4, Starscream will be number 3. There's Megatron just fitting in there. There is Blur, of course, was the first one. And then, although they weren't released as special editions, it's all pretty much the same toy line. We've got Optimus Prime. And of course, we've got Ratchet there, which came in that twin pack. So I'm sure he'll agree, they all look very good and also very strange in their own right. Again, just a brilliant figure. It is good. I know it's Hasbro using the same molds again, but I think with this particular figure and this particular story, it just really, really works. It's entirely up to you guys. If you've not yet experienced this mold, it is very, very good. Very, very good indeed, to be honest. And it displays so well in all the modes that you can display it with. I'm going to round this up by putting how I'm going to be displaying him. So I'm going to put the back of him up on there like so. I'm going to split the guns into two pieces, and I'm going to put the shoulder cannon on as well. And again, it just means that I can store everything nice and neat without worrying about losing anything. I'm going to leave the one gun with nothing on, and I'm going to leave this gun with the two bits over the side. But you can even, as I say, adjust these, take these off, etc., put them wherever you want. I'm going to go with that, I think, for this particular guy, just because it's totally out there and it looks a little different. But there you go. Hope you enjoyed looking at him. Again, you can tell I'm impressed with him. I think he's brilliant. Bonus thing, if you do order from Hasbro Pulse, remember you do get the free comic that comes with it. I'm not too sure where else to get it from, to be honest. I know in the UK it's not really available anywhere else apart from where I've just said. But yeah, I've definitely seen him on lots of people's Instagram, so I'm sure you can be able to track him down if you do want one yourself. But there he is, guys. Shattered Glass Goldbug. Thanks for watching. Like and comment. And don't forget to subscribe.